जेजी एन्ड नाज। जब हिपहपमा रियल एमसिजहरूको ऱ्याप ब्याटलको कुरा आउँछ, जेजी र नाजले होल टपिकलाई नै कभर गर्छन्। आजसम्म हिपहपको हिस्ट्रीमै ब्याक टु ब्याक डिस रेकर्ड निकाल्न र हिपहप चार्ट्सदेखि स्ट्रिटसम्मलाई रुल गर्नमा कुनै अरू ऱ्यापर्सहरूले सफलता हासिल गर्न सकेका छैनन्। जसलाई कुनै समयमा हिपहपकै दोस्रो सबैभन्दा डरलाग्दो र तीव्र झगडा मानिन्थ्यो, आज त्यो दुश्मनी एन्ड भएको 16 वर्ष भइसक्यो। जब हिपहपले ऱ्यापको दुई मेन पात्र टुपाक र बिगीलाई गुमाएका थिए, त्यसको ठिक 9 वर्षपछि जेजी र नाजले पनि सँगै लाइभ पर्फर्म र इन्टरभ्यू दिएर आफ्नो बिफलाई अन्त्य गरेका थिए।
The two of you coming together at this point is not just important for music, but it's, in my opinion, it's important for the streets and the people that you reach through your music. So this is a very important moment right here, you know. And at one point, in the midst of your beef, I had a chance to speak to both of you individually. And I said, and Jay, you may recall, is there ever the possibility that you would ever work with the man sitting next to you?
There wasn't collaborations before anything happened, so... You know, why would it happen after?
So now the streets is watching, they're definitely talking. Why here and why now?
It's bigger than both of us because it's not really about us. I mean, it is, but it really isn't. You know what I'm saying? It's more so about the culture and also about the ending and also about showing people another way. Because what we staged was something just stopped the world for a second.
But it was always respect. It wasn't a point where, you know, he wanted to gun me down. I wanted to gun him. It was never that, you know, because that's not how I think how real bosses move or how real men move. I'm a fan of rap, you know, and I don't have to front like a lot of artists today want to front and be as big as the biggest ones were. Like, they want to go from 0 to 60. As soon as they start their career, they come out slandering people, acting, you know, crazy. And this is another way for it to go.
I mean, even in the mix of everything that we was going through as far as battle, which was a battle, you know what I'm saying? You know, there was a deep respect there. I mean, to go at someone like that, you have to have respect for them, or else you wouldn't care. You just brush it off. Like, it ain't about nothing.
जब रेस्पेक्टको कुरा आउँछ जेजी र नाजको लेभलमा, त्यो कुनै गीत वा कुनै इन्टरभ्यूमा एकअर्काको तारिफ गर्ने मात्र नभएर त्योभन्दा माथि छ। जुन दुवै आर्टिस्टहरूले जेजीको आई डिक्लेयर वार नामक कन्सर्टमा सँगै पर्फर्म गरेर प्रुफ दिएका थिए
2006। What was originally meant to be a lyrical smackdown for Jigga's foes instead became a statement of unity.
The moment you guys met on stage at the I Declare War concert, describe that feeling. What did you feel at that point?
It was unreal, surreal. It was a second of like, you know, are we seeing that? Then it was just pandemonium.
It was crazy, it was chilling. And I felt like, wow, dang, this is that moment. And there may have been other times when I'm like, wow, I sold a lot of records on that album. Or, wow, I made history right here, but it's like, dang, this moment right here, I never saw it coming.
If there was any reservation still, at that point, it was all gone. Like, yeah, you know what? We are doing the right thing.
I want to ask you guys now, you seem like you have a great rapport. You know, you guys seem like the energy is right. I'm feeling the energy in the room, you know, and the world has stopped once more because of Jay-Z and Nas. But what is the nature of your relationship now? Are you friends?
Somebody asked me the other day, I was like, this, you know, this isn't like high school. You know, you don't sit down with people and be like, you know, so we friends now. You know what I'm saying? That's just not a reality, you know? But anything that's shrouded in respect can grow.
I mean, what was the first thing you guys said to each other?
I don't know if you remember, but first thing that happened is we gave a pound and busted out laughing.
Yeah. Why?
It's funny. Because it's one of those things, like, at the time, you would never think would happen in life. And it's happened, so it was funny.
जब जेजी र नाजले यो पोजिटिभ मुभ चलाएर हिपहप कम्युनिटीमा नयाँ म्यासेज पुर्याएका थिए, थुप्रै हिपहप फ्यान्सहरूले यसलाई पब्लिसिटी स्टन्ट भन्दै अझै बिफ हुनसक्ने भन्ने सोच राखेका थिए। तर जब नाजले आफू हिपहपमा आएदेखि साइन भएको म्युजिक लेबल कोलम्बियालाई छोडेर डेफ ज्याम रेकर्ड लेबलमा साइन भए, जसको प्रेसिडेन्ट जेजी थिए, त्यो बेला धेरै हिपहप फ्यान्सहरूले मनमा यो क्वेसन उठाएकी थिए कि के नाज अब जेजीको इम्प्लोय नै भएको हो त।
Are you concerned with the appearance that Nas scored well in the battle, but he just signed a Jay? Jay wins the war.
Not at all. Me coming over to Def Jam is, I'm bringing something to the table. I'm equivalent to 20 of these artists. You know, not Def Jam, Sony, or whatever. I'm just saying, wherever I go. And the bottom line is the movement is bigger than what someone says about Nas for the moment. I've always had someone say something about me. I'm one of the most crucified artists in the game. And when people have negative things to say, it's all good, man. And I think that they really, really, at the end of the day, respect the move. And they really do understand the move. Mm-hmm. Really do.
We're thinking bigger than, you know, what was said on the record. We're thinking bigger than, you know, what people perceive this as. Mm-hmm. You know, we're thinking as grown men, and we're also thinking as responsible grown men. We've been chosen as leaders. We have to lead. We can't follow what people's perception of this union is. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? I didn't sign Nas. I partnered with Nas. I mean, you can't sign a artist of Nas' stature.
Mm-hmm.
You can only partner with him.
अब त्यो मोमेन्ट आइसकेको थियो कि हिपहपको हिस्ट्रीमै टु अफ द इलेस्ट एमसिजहरूले आफ्नो इस्युजलाई साइडमा राखेर हिपहपको सेकको लागि कोलाबरेसन गर्नुपर्ने थियो तर छ वर्ष अगाडि एउटा र्युमर आएको थियो कि जेजेले नासको डेड प्रेसिडेन्ट गीतको स्याम्पल युज गरेका थिए त्यसपछि दुईजनाले एकअर्कालाई डिस रेकर्डमा च्यालेन्ज गर्ने मात्र नभएर अब बिगी पछिको न्युयोर्क किङ अफ ऱ्याप को हुने भन्ने टपिकलाई लिएर चर्चा बढ्न लाग्यो
किङ इन न्युयोर्क थिङ you know is that thing that started rap
hey little soldier you ain't ready for war ROC too strong for y'all
how much of Biggie's rhymes is gonna come out your fat lips wanted to be on every last one of my classics
तर दुईजनै आर्टिस्टको फ्यानहरू बीचमा लाइन ड्र भइसकेको थियो जसले गर्दा फ्यान्सहरूले पर्टिकुलर आर्टिस्टको साइड लिन सुरु गरिसकेका थिए
Jay.
All I can say is Nas.
Jay-Z.
Nas really ripped it.
I don't like Jay-Z.
QB prevailed.
Of course not.
A lot of slurs thrown, a lot of horrible metaphors thrown back and forth at each other. And at one point, you even challenged Nas to a boxing match.
That's light. That's gloves and headgear. You know what I'm saying? That wouldn't have been nothing.
That would have been nothing.
You know, saying boxing was a clean way. I wasn't on the radio saying, you know, when I see him, it's on. Just, you know, ridiculous with it. But when you're in it, you're in it.
तर जब लिरिकल एसासिनेसनको टपिक आउँछ ऱ्यापमा अझ इन टर्म्स अफ स्कोरिङ तब कुनै लाइन हुँदैन जसले बार्स ब्रुटालिटी छुँदैन जब जेजीले 2001 टेकओभर ऱ्यापको अनकट भर्जन निकाले जुन एउटा कम्प्लिट भर्बल भेनम थियो त्यो न्युयोर्कको हट 97 रेडियो स्टेसनमा एयर गरियो त्यसपछि जेजीले नासँगसँगै न्युयोर्कको क्विन्स ब्रिजको अर्को फाइनेस्ट ऱ्यापर मब डिपलाई पनि टार्गेट गरे त्यसको ठिक एक वर्षपछि फेरि नाजले रिटालिएसनको फर्ममा त्यही रेडियो स्टेसन हट 97 कन्सर्टमा पर्फर्म गर्ने प्लान गरेका थिए जुन पछि नाजले एउटा अनकन्ट्रोलेबल ब्लिफ सुरु हुन्छ भन्ने सोचमा पर्फर्म गरेनन्
I had a big show put together. I was going to actually crucify Jay at Hot 97 show.
When that battle was going down, when it took place, was there anything that he said that made you go, woo? He hit me hard with that.
Nah, because I was in it. Mm-hmm. So I wasn't viewing it from a statistical point of view. I was like, you know, I felt there was things that were said that was on over the line that made me say things that was over the line.
And since you infatuated with saying that gay, yes, she was kissing my, you was kissing that.
It's unsaid things, like, you know, where you from where we grew up
mm-hmm.
and once you say certain things you know you've crossed the line
in 88 you was getting chased to your building calling my crib and I ain't even give you my numbers
when you heard the verse from the takeover it didn't at all make you go damn Jay ain't playing he's serious
yeah, honestly at first I was like whatever but the streets wasn't letting me let it go like that
mm-hmm.
so and then I had to really pay attention and when I did pay attention I realized it was really on
It seemed like that battle kind of, not that you were asleep, but it kind of sparked you.
Yo, I know you ain't talking about me, dog. You? What?
Brought out the old nasty Nas.
Oh, yeah. In the midst of a battle, you know, you never know how it's going to turn out because everything's at stake. So it was like, I thought it was personal. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, it was on.
In the takeover, you summarized Nas's career to one hot album in the 10-year average, and then you went on to imply that the knowledge he kicks is garbage.
When the war is going on, all you're trying to do is you're trying to
you're trying to point out things that is popular. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That you're gonna get the most people.
One line that I think, when everybody knew that Jay had the gloves off, was the line in Takeover, that if I could paraphrase what he says.
I don't want to say the line that he said.
Because you know who.
I did you know what, with you know who. But we're going to leave that between me and you, and just kind of left everybody hanging. And it turned out that he was alluding to your child's mother.
How do you respond to that? Because no matter what you say, that's a hard line.
Not very many people come back after that. The Takeovers, that was like the figure four leg lock.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, you can't get out of that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't escape that one. So it was a whole level of respect. Like, okay. The whole level of respect.
And then I just lit back. A bomb.
Put your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you. Nah. Godson across the belly.
Lose.
I prove you lost the race.
तर जब जेजी र नाजले त्यो फ्युडलाई एन्ड गरेको म्यासेज पब्लिक भयो तब सबै रियल हिपहप हेड्सहरूको माइन्डमा एउटा मात्रै प्रश्न चलिरहेको थियो के यो फ्युड एन्ड गर्न थट 81 मनमा कसरी आयो
आई थिंक देयर वाज अ मोमेन्ट इभन व्हेन जे वाज लाइक ऑन द रेडियो एन्ड ही वाज लाइक यो यू नो मॉम सेड चिल हिज मॉम वाज टेलिंग हिम इट वाज लाइक एंड माय मॉम ब्लेस हर वाज लिसनिंग एंड आई वाज लाइक वाओ दैट्स व्हाट आई न्यू वी बोथ वेंट टू फार
How does that make you guys look, though? If you make this big stance that we're coming together, forming a union, y'all saw what happened. You saw what happened with Biggie and Pac. They never got a chance to resolve their situation. Look what we're doing as Jay-Z and Nas.
After Biggie and Pac left, there's a lot of MCs out there, but I really don't see many that really stand the test of time that are true warriors. And mm-hmm. when we went to war, we killed everything out there. There was only me and him left on the battlefield. What else do these warriors do? Do they still fight it out to the end, or do they now come together?
It's like saying Frazier and Ali. Like, you know, things were said then, but, you know, it's in the spirit of competition. I for not one second could ever say I don't believe that he's one of the best lyricists ever.
But you still got a lot of people, Nas, that want to get at you on the mic. They want to get at you on records, on wax, and probably will. They're going to make fun of y'all union. They're going to say, look at them now. They friendly, they're nice, they're hugged up.
It's not that we hugging up and all that. We showed the world something for ourselves and for the fans. We did this for them. They can have that. Hang the post up, I'll sign it for you. Mm-hmm. But that's done. Now we're moving on. They got to let it go. Let it go.
Let it go?
Let it go.
Okay.
तर जब जेजी र नाजले आफ्नो बिफलाई एन्ड गरेर अगाडि बढ्ने सोच राखे तब अरू एमसिजहरूले त्यो कुरालाई ट्रोल गर्दै र उनीहरूलाई आफ्नो ट्र्याकमा नाम दिँदै बिफको लागि उक्साउन थाले
You and 50 have been at a war of words for the past however long, a year or so. And same now with you and Cameron.
I've never really been in a word war with 50. You know, 50 came up with me. You know, like I brought him on tours with me and I like him a lot. Had a lot of love for him. And to tell you something real, I think what happened was he was hurt by me, by certain things he thought that I did were against him in certain ways that he didn't understand moves I was making. And his thing is, you know, he's gonna say whatever's on his mind. And sometimes, you know, he don't know when to stop. And I think he just got to get those things off his chest. But I never really had any word plan. Of course, I say a little things here and there, but you know what? At the end of the day, I know it was hurt.
Say, for example, in your case, Jay, you got an interesting dilemma because now you wear a suit and you wear the hoodie, you know, and you got a former artist that's getting at you. The thing to me that got you to the position you are now was your credibility as an MC. But man, if you move as an MC, how does that affect your
right.
credibility as a CEO?
Well, I don't think the record questions, I mean, or ever could question my credibility as an MC.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not anything challenging enough or artistic enough. It's not even well thought out. So I don't think it challenges anything.
I mean, it's just how I feel. If you listen to the song, if I say somebody looks like a camel, they look like a camel. If I say somebody has sandals on, they have on sandals. If you retaliate or whatever, we'll be prepared.
And if at some time I feel like swinging back, like De Niro and he, you know, cleaning that garbage up, you know, I might do that. You know what I'm saying? But it's nothing that deserves my immediate attention.
Okay, well, that's what I, because you two are like the two deadliest MCs to ever battle. Okay, let's call it that. And I know it was in your heart, man. I know y'all hip-hop.
You want the record, ask for it, man. Just
okay.
Say,
yeah, you got the record.
Yeah, yeah.
The Jay, give me the record.
You want it, right?
The record is
you want to hear it, right?
So I want to know that you made it. Did you make the record?
No, I didn't make it. I ain't make it.
You haven't made a record?
Not yet.
Not yet. But there's always a possibility.
Yeah.
But if someone comes after Nas, y'all team now, you guys got to protect your investment. What does that mean? Does Jay come to Nas's defense at some point? Does Nas come to Jay's defense?
Honestly, I don't really see any competition his way coming at him for me to come for his defense. I don't think he sees any competition my way. We haven't had one conversation. I haven't talked to you really about right. that. Maybe once or twice, little small things, but that's all it is. I haven't seen any real threats. I've only seen how this has threatened them.
All beats aside, this is a business. And it'll be interesting to see how President Carter deals with an artist who's enjoyed more critical acclaim than commercial success.
Your last two albums, Street Disciples and Godson, people will argue that, you know, it wasn't commercial enough. That's not necessarily good business for someone like you.
Yeah, but don't turn me into just the guy with the suit, you know. I think we should double the chorus type of guy, okay? Don't turn me in that. I'm a creative guy.
Let's not forget, art can sell. You ain't gotta front all the time on your record. Art can sell. He's proven that, I've proven that.
Jay, let me ask you this, man, because you collaborated with big name artists in the past, namely R. Kelly. It didn't go too well, you know, in the end. Did you have any concerns with Nas at all?
That's different. Like, we made an album together, me and R. Kelly. This is Nas's album. You know, it's his artistic direction and expression and where he sees himself going. I'm talking about, like, you ain't here.
Yeah, like, put it like this. Like, I look at this because he's an MC. I would love for this man to be around while I'm making this and vice versa. We have an understanding of music which makes our bond better when we're talking about creating and when we're talking about art. You know what I'm saying? So that's what the process is like, I feel.
With the business of Nas and his album settled, the question remains, will Jay-Z, the MC, ever bless the mic again?
There's been a lot of speculation that you're gonna come back with an S. Dot Carter album.
Was that because that's not a Jay-Z album? Like, that makes me a different person?
Hey, man, you're a tricky guy. You know, it ain't always what it seems.
So they say.
You know.
Personally, I feel like, Jay, I feel like you got to come back out. That's just me because, you know, if me and him don't do that, we leave a lot of people out there that's like, what's going on?
I'm curious to this, too, because we discussed this before when you were actually promoting the Linkin Park album that you did. The possibility of you two doing an album together. At that time, you said no.
Right.
It looks like it's more of a possibility than ever right now. Is that possible that Nas and Jay would do an album together?
Well, first things first. Next question. I ain't ready for that one.
Y'all want to breathe on that?
Let us walk.
After this, they did numerous tracks and live shows together.